Hello guys, so in this video we will learn another approach to solving the master's method. In this one we just formulate the three cases of master method in a table, and based on this table you can find out the time complexity of any recurrence relation which can be solved by the master's method. So we have divided the master method in calculating two intermediate functions. One is we have to calculate the function h of n, and then another is we have to calculate the function v of n. So based on the value of h of n, we look up the table and find out the value of v of n, and based on the value of v of n, we can finally calculate the value of t of n. So it is very easy approach. By this approach we can easily we are not required to memorize all the cases of the master's method, and we can easily find out the time complexity of any recurrence relation. Okay, so I just explain you about the table. So first thing is how to calculate the h of n. So it is a ratio of the factor which is considered by the standard master method, and log a to the power b and log a base b, and we have to calculate the ratio of f of n and this factor. Then whatever the value comes out from this ratio, so this is nothing but comparison between this factor and the value of fn. We also done it within the standard master's method. So in a standard master method, case one says that if your function fn grows polynomially slower than this factor, then we consider that a case. So similarly, we have make this in a table, and we say that if the value of this this calculation is negative, means your function fn is slower, then only it is negative. So whenever it is the case, so then the time complexity is order of 1, means it will kept as n to the power that factor, n to the power log a base b, and into order of 1, means this is the first case. You can see the Corman, and in that Corman book you can find out this. In case 1, the recurrence relation is given by n to the power log a base b. In second case, it is similar to the second case of the standard books defined in Corman. It says that when you both of the function function and the factor f of n and n to the power log a base b grows similar or behave in similar rates, okay, then we lie in the second row of this table, and it shows that for all type of constant relations we have to make the form of that relation into log n to the power I. So for any relation we have to make such forms if it lies in the second quadrant, second row, and then find out the value of v of n, like order of log n to the power I plus 1 upon I plus 1. Then in third one, when your fn is asymptotically faster than your considered factor n to the power log a base b, in that case we have to find out the value of n to the power r, where r is greater than 0, and the time complexity is the value of v of n is equal to order of n to the power r, and we multiply that factor into the n to the power log a base b and find out the value of tn. So let's solve some of the questions based on this approach. Question number 1, if you want to solve this t of n is equal to t n by 2 plus c, find the value of a is equal to 1, b is equal to 2, and value of fn is equal to c. Then we calculate the value of hn, which is comes out to be c to the c upon and the factor log a is 1, b is b, it is c to the upon n to the power 0, or we can say that it is c. So when it is c, it means it is some constant value. We consider it as a 1 or something. So the constant value always lie in the second row, and we have to make that into a form of log. So I can rewrite this same thing with the log n to the power 0 for the value I is equal to 0. Okay, now we can find out the value of vn for this. Order of log n to the power 0 plus 1 divided by 0 plus 1, it means it is nothing but order of log n. And we can also find out the value of tn is equal to n to the power log a is 1, b is 2, into the value of vn, that means order of log n and by combining it we can say that n to the power 0 into order of log n, or we can say that it is order of log n. Okay, so this is how we can find out the time complexity of this relation. Now similarly we can solve another example. So let's solve another example.